Good morning. It is June 21st, 2020. My name is George Reiser. I'm the pastor at Holy Trinity United Church of Christ. I want to welcome you to our online service. Today in the liturgical calendar is the third Sunday after Pentecost. It is also Father's Day. Very early in on the service, I want to do just a brief explanation. For several years recently, there's been some discussion about the antecedents and history of Mother's Day, Father's Day, and the concerns among some folks about the nature of Mother's Day, Father's Day, and so on. And as a result of that concern, it is my intention as the pastor of Holy Trinity to acknowledge and recognize those folks who have served in the capacity, boy, that sounds official, served in the capacity or fulfilled the responsibilities and duties and the love and the nurturing of someone who has been a father or a father figure, who's done those responsibilities for a child and has shared that nurturing experience. So no matter who you are, what your station or situation with the child or the young adult that you have nurtured and cared for, I want to share God's blessings and the well wishes for those who are observing Father's Day this day. As we come to our time of worship, our centering words and thoughts for this day are as follows. Great are the works of God's hands. Wondrous are the blessings of Christ's love. Holy are the works of God's Spirit. We think of the Holy Trinity, our church, as inclusive, accepting, helping, and making a difference in the community around us and in the world. I want to invite you to join us during this time of pandemic where our worship can only be limited to online. I want to invite you to join us on Facebook at 10 o'clock each Sunday morning. You can find us on Facebook.com at HTUCCNJ or after the live worship, the recording is available on YouTube and you just search HTUCCNJ. Welcome. Our call to worship. When we have been cast aside in the deserts of our lives, you open our eyes to life-giving water that sustains us in our need. When our future seems lost and others have taken our place of honor, you restore our hope and promise us an inheritance of our own. Who is like you among the gods? Who answers prayer in times of deepest need? We are here to worship you, O God, for you alone can save us. At this time, I invite you to share aloud, wherever you are, what you're doing, whatever your station in life, I invite you to share our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our first music of the worship time, each worship, is what I call our coffee warm-up music. This is your time to informally hear our warm-up music, warm up your coffee, nibble a bite of toast, but even more important, it is a time for us to share in centering, in reflecting, and may we know that God is good. Our prayer of confession is the only time during this online virtual worship that I invite you to do a responsive reading. It's not something that's easy to handle remotely in virtual time, but this is the only prayer that we share that way, and I will pray first, chunking the groups of words, and invite you to join along to follow. Holy One, your words cause us to tremble. Nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not be known. There is much in our lives that we wish to hide from others, even ourselves. We fear those who kill the body while ignoring those who kill the soul. Teach us once more, O God, that your Son came to bring us life, even if turned son against father and daughter against mother. Remind us of our higher calling and the promises you offer of life in your realm, which has no end. Amen. And now I invite you to join in 15 or 20 seconds of reflection, contemplation, consideration. Those who seek to preserve their life will lose it, but those who lose their life for Christ's sake will find it. Those who have died with Christ through baptism are united with him in his resurrection. Into God's presence we come, and from that presence we are forgiven, blessed, and sustained. Amen. Status of Holy Trinity's worship has not changed, although there are a lot of things that are changing in terms of the pandemic. for the moment, given the New Jersey regulations, the state and community regulations, as well as the information and guidance of the Central Atlantic Conference of our denomination, Holy Trinity will, the sanctuary will not be used for gathering before July 19th at the earliest. Certainly, if that changes for any reason, and things are changing drastically and rapidly, and who knows what each day brings, we will keep you informed. Please be safe. One quick reminder, the first Sunday of each month is communion. We will join in communion remotely in virtual worship, and that will be the first Sunday. I want to invite you to send any announcements. I want to hear from you. At this particular time, because of the pandemic, because of the nature of our society and our culture, I want to emphasize who and what we are as community, as the beloved community of Holy Trinity. You can send announcements by email, by the United States Postal Service, by Facebook, by text messages, by Messenger. I think I've told folks anything. I don't care if you put a note into a bottle and toss it into the Delaware. Let us know what's going on. We'd love to hear from you. In fact, this week I've received emails, texts, calls, social media texts, messages, Messenger messages from Henrietta, Bill. I've heard from Mike and Marge, from David and Angie, from Linda Mosgrove, and in the spirit of community, many of you know that for now, recently, I've started asking you for pictures or videos that relate to the theme of our worship and scripture on each day. So I've received pictures from from Mike and Marge, from Aaron, from David and Angie, and from Bill. So thank you very, very much. The theme for today's photo album is shadows, or the idea of light and dark. And again, in our efforts to build community, it's absolutely wonderful the folks who are willing to share and to be creative and bring forward the thoughts and pictures of relating to today's theme. Many thanks, folks. From Bill, I received, Bill reached into his host of pictures and sent several that illustrated the idea of shadows or of light and dark images. I'll just mention a few of them. One of them, lower left, is a line of trees, a tree line at sunset. Right next to that, there's a neat picture that Bill took in a cave that we're going through exploring a tour with. The third picture on the bottom is a picture from Bill's condo at night, and again a neat illustration of shadows and the light and dark concept. Angie and David sent along this great picture that has a light and dark theme to it. The light angel statue and the darker walkway and flagstones. This picture that Angie and David sent, as well as the next couple pictures, are neat in that we've shadows and light theme that actually incorporate some flowers. Mike and Marge sent along these two, and just it's a nice, bright, very engaging, sunny day. But the juxtaposition of the bright flowers and the deep shadows in this bright sunny day are just neat pictures. And again, I greatly appreciate the theme of light and dark. Aaron sent along these two pictures. The first one is AJ, my grandson, and I just like the black and white picture that he sent, or that she sent, of him, that has the bright sun in the top, and again the neat dark and light juxtaposition, and the same thing with the kind of a solarized contrasty picture of the wedding of Aaron and Angie, where I was walking Aaron down the aisle. So many thanks to everybody who's willing to contribute to our community idea, community thoughts, and each week's theme for worship. I have two brief numbers from Stephen Aiken for our celebration music today. The first is My Help Comes from the Lord, and kind of relating to Father's Day, this brief verse from This Is My Father's World.
Share. This is my Father's will, and let me never forget that though the wrongs is oft so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is my Father's world. Why should my heart feel sad? The Lord is King.
We come to our time of prayer where we will share our concerns, we will share our thanksgivings, we will share our praise and our celebration. If you know someone who is in need of prayer, please let me know. You can email me at george.riser@gmail.com. You can send me mail at the church address. It's here. It'll be on the screen a couple times during worship. Box 2249, Willingboro, 08046. If we are to be the beloved community, if we are to be Holy Trinity as a community, a family of loving, caring, concerned neighbors, I want to hear from you. We need to be in communion, in sharing with one another. This day, we're lifting in prayer all of those who are in either in fear or enraged. Those are legitimate concerns that we have because of systemic racism in our nation. And we have a concern about a nation that's not yet awakened to the dangers of racism, the horrible cost of racism, the problems inherent in institutionalized racism. We lift in prayer also all who are in long-term or residential facilities. I ask for prayer for Bud Lamson's mother. Also, I ask for prayer for Devin Lamson, who has surgery impending. You'll hear more about that as that time comes, and we will keep an eye on her progress. Also, a friend of Linda Mosgrove, Karen, had surgery, and we lift her up in celebration for success. It's still a long haul for the recovery steps, but we certainly are appreciative of the surgical success. I also want to lift up a friend of Bill's, Father Ron Hoskins, who passed away Juneteenth. On June 19th, he had cancer, Father Hoskins was just a brilliantly loving person who was active in Dignity Philadelphia. So our prayers to that community and to his family and friends. Certainly also the agonizing numbers of victims and deaths from COVID-19, and it's right now it's at the point where there are three kind of groupings, states that are where the virus is receding a little bit, states that are maintaining, and just recently, within the past week and a half, several states that have had growth and increase in the virus. Also, Betty Kimball, who is at Burlington Woods, we have been following her, and turns out that she has been spared most of the bad symptoms of the virus, and it is with celebration and thanksgiving that that she's recovering and doing so well. So we lift her in prayer. Please join with me in a now of a time of prayer. Holy God, we are called to glorify you. Help us to acknowledge you with the praise and the honor accorded to you, the master builder, the architect of the universe. We're called to offer our best behavior and our most intense faith. We sometimes stumble in that offer, and we now acknowledge our failings, and we offer you our contrite and our repentant hearts. Forgive us our selfish and self-serving ways, and our ways when they wander into meanness or guile. Forgive us the large and the small, for we've sinned in ways that are too numerous to mention, too numerous to count. Accept our thanks for your mighty and divine forgiveness, for you are loving and forgiving and merciful and just. Accept also our thanks for all that you have given us. We truly are a blessed people, and we frequently forget the level of our blessing and the level of your love and provision. We are blessed despite our trials and tribulations, despite the pandemic, the racial unrest, in a society that should mirror the best and the brightest of our natures, but sometimes doesn't. Sometimes we fail. We're called to offer prayers of request. You instruct us to be in prayer and to look to you for your care, and to look to others to offer our care to them and offer our concern for others. Many are wanting this day. Many are hurting or are in need. We lift them up. Bless us in our attempts to walk in your ways and to walk in your will. We ask that we may be made more like the people we are called to be. We're called to offer ourselves. We are your children, your beloved community, as I said earlier. We ask that God hasten the day when we may know your love eternal and immense. All glory be to you, Holy God the Creator, and Jesus the Divine Teacher and Example, and to the Holy Spirit, God with us, abiding and sustaining, now and forever, world without end. Amen. And now we come to a time of giving. I invite you to give because it is our nature as the children of God to be giving and caring. And your gifts make a difference. Certainly making a difference to maintain and sustain the church, but more importantly, to maintain and sustain the mission and witness of the children of God, sharing with those in need. Again, our address is Box 2249, Willingboro, 08046. Two scripture lessons this morning. The first is from the Hebrew scriptures, and the second will be from the gospel reading. Our Hebrew scripture lesson this morning comes from Jeremiah 20:7-13. O Lord, you have enticed me, and I was enticed. You have overpowered me, and you have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all day long. Everyone mocks me, for whenever I speak, I must cry out, I must shout, violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and derision all day long. If I say I will not mention him, or speak any more in his name, then within me there is something like a burning fire shut up in my bones. I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. For I hear many whispering, terror is all around. Denounce him. Let us denounce him. All my close friends are watching for me to stumble. Perhaps he can be enticed, and we can prevail against him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me like a dread warrior. Therefore my persecutors will stumble, and they will not prevail. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, you test the righteous. You see the heart and the mind. Let me see your retribution upon them. For to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers. Our gospel reading today comes from Matthew 10, verses 24 through 39. A disciple is not above the teacher, nor a slave above the master. It is enough for the disciple to be like the teacher and the slave like the master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much will they malign those of his household? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted, so do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone therefore who acknowledges me before others, I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I also will deny before my Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to the earth. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, and a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's foes will be members of one's own household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who will find their life will lose it. And those who lose their life for my sake will find it. May God bless the reading, hearing, the understanding, and the acting upon this portion of God's holy and divine word. I promise it's going to be short, but I have so much to say. In this time, in this culture, in our society, where right now, it almost seems like there are two things, and only two things. It seems like we have forgotten climate change. We have forgotten a lot that is going on in our world these days, and everything seems centered around the pandemic and around the current racial unrest. There are dichotomies, there are weights. A lot going on here, a lot going on there. And I want to talk with you briefly and share with you an idea about the relativity of weights and two sides and the idea of shadows and dark and light. And make no mistake, good and evil. There are relative goods, there are relative evils, and I want to talk about what Jesus is talking about in Matthew's passage, and that is priority and primacy. And what's important. The reality is, in our world right now, in all of our big issues, climate change, racial unrest, the COVID pandemic, there is a continuum, certainly, but there are evils and goods. And we need to look at those, and I mean really look at those, and then think about where we stand and how we are loved and dealt with in a godly fashion. It's tough to, for example, racial unrest. The reality is that we have a horrible, horrible history of evil on the North American continent. The horrible evil of slavery and what that has meant to us in the North American continent and in America for the past 400 years is an evil that we have to accept and that we can't hide and that we can't deny. It's sometimes we try to, sometimes we pretend it's not that way. The shadows and the dark and light are very real, and we need to name the evil. The same thing is true with institutionalized racism and white privilege. The reality is that we can't, there's a lot of gray, but we can't ignore the fact that there are a lot of evils out there. The same thing's true with COVID. All the way from people like the first responders, the nurses and doctors who put themselves out there and deal with that deadly concern day after day, to the tune of what, 120,000 deaths now or nearly that. So and contrast that with people who refuse to be concerned for the other person, who can't wear a mask where masks are warranted and needed. There are darks and lights, and we need to be aware of them. We need to be the light. We need to be looking for, as Jesus says in Matthew, we need to be looking for the person whose life belongs to God. Because in this mishmash, the hodgepodge or any other cliched word that you want to use, in this life, as troubled and tortured and tormented and with so much going on, we need to be looking to God for the good. We need to be aware that the evil is there, and we need to be naming the evil, and we need to be confronting evil. But we need to be lifting up, embracing, and being open to the good. And that's going to be when we're in the presence of God as the people of God, the loving community of God. May the good be around us and through us and in us and part of who we are. May the good that we see as a result of God's way and God's will and God's love, may that good make us the people that we need to be and the community that we need to be. May that be our prayer, and may that be our ministry and mission of love. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, amen. And now, beloved community, though we have been cast aside, you restore our future. Though others seek to banish us from sight, you bless us with opportunities for new life. Go with the blessings of the one who loves us fiercely. We go to share God's love with the world. Amen. So be it. Amen.
He saw me in